So we are here at the headquarters of iFixit. I'm here with Kyle. He's the CEO of iFixit, and we're talking about cell phones, repairability, and durability. So Kyle, I have a question for you.
All right.
We're pretty into the repairing of cell phones. What for you is the ideal cell phone? So we have different materials that can be made out of, plastic, glass, or metal. Which one do you prefer?
Well, I like quality materials. So if you look at, I mean, the higher end flagship phones, they're investing more in the materials. The iPhone is a very durable phone in general. So I think that there's a lot to be said for what Apple's done. I have an iPhone. So in general, like the metal that they have done, right? It has a pretty good build quality. I have here, this is a like $50 Android phone that they sell in India. And I mean, this is reasonable. This is more close to like an old school Nokia phone.
Yeah.
But I definitely like, you know, robust, durable materials. I don't really have any problem with the metal. I think you could also build a plastic phone that stood the test of time, but it would probably need to be a higher quality plastic than you see here, and maybe a little bit thicker.
Okay. So in your ideal smartphone, would it be metal or plastic? You have to pick just one.
I have to pick.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could go either way. I mean, I just want a rugged case. So if it's metal that's taking the impact, if it's plastic, I can go either way. But I think that, you know, in your bend test, you've shown that, I mean, if you go with like the plastic phone you've got over there, that's the extreme side of flimsy plastic.
Yeah.
But I think you can do some things with polycarbonate. So I would say I'm more about the functionality, and I don't really care how you get there.
Okay. And so as far as like, what about internals go? So when you go to buy a smartphone, you have the iPhone right now, what is the most important aspect for you as far as repairability, you know, battery life? What do you look for?
Yeah, so the crazy thing about most phones these days is it's gotten really commoditized, right? Like there isn't as big a difference between all the phones on the market as there was 3-4 years ago. So everything has a camera. The flagship phones all have pretty good cameras. So we can sit here and we can really nitpick the difference. But the difference between an S7 camera and an iPhone 6S camera isn't huge, right? They're both really good cameras within the form factor. What I would say is make the thing bigger. Like, I actually don't need a bigger screen. I think this screen could even be made a bit smaller. But, like, give me more room for the camera. Or, like, the biggest design flaw with the iPhone, and I have my own bump that I added, but the design flaw is the camera bump, right? So they could have given me 25% better battery life if they just made the entire phone as thick as the camera.
Yeah.
So they're sitting here, and, like, it's funny when you see interviews with Johnny, you know, Apple's famous designer, and you say, yeah, what do you think about the bump? And he's like, well, we had to do that. Well, you didn't have to do that. You could have made the phone thicker.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be my, like, make the phone a bit thicker, give us a bit longer battery. The phone battery is going to degrade. Like, after you've had it for a year or two, you're going to, you know, get dramatically less life out of the same battery. So we should design the phone to have maybe 150% more battery than you need, so that a year from now, when the capacity is shrunk, it's still functional.
Yeah, and so it'll last more charge cycles because there's more
right
life in there.
Exactly. And we see that with the iPads. Like, an iPad has a battery that, like, nobody really burns through an iPad battery in a day, right?
Yeah.
It takes a couple days to work through it. And so it's not until you've had an iPad for 3 or 4 years that you really need to change the battery. Where on a phone, you need to swap the battery every year. So if we're in this constraint where we're saying, well, we have the phones that we have now, I would like to see a battery that's easy to swap. So my ideal phone, like my favorite phone out there on the market right now, is the Fairphone. And unfortunately, and I can't use one myself because it's only works on the European frequencies right now. So I'm hoping that the Fairphone 3 comes to the U.S. But it's designed, you don't need any tools to swap the battery. You don't even need any tools to swap the screen. It's just plastic tabs and it comes out.
That'd be perfect. And that's because that phone is pretty modular, right?
It's designed to be extremely modular for repairability, not modular for functionality.
Okay.
So you can't swap out a better camera on it, but it is easy if the camera fails to swap it out.
To just put in the same component again. That's good. So just to summarize, the ideal phone for the iFixit CEO would be a phone that has a rigid case on it, so like it won't bend or damage easily, and a bigger battery than what is currently in most flagships.
And a battery that you can swap yourself. And then the other things that I would say is it should have a repair manual that's publicly available, and there should be parts available. And what's crazy is that the Fairphone is the only phone in the world that has a repair manual and parts available from the manufacturer. None of the other companies do it. Even the Indian smartphone companies, even, you know, Samsung, Apple, HTC, Huawei, none of them are making repair information available. And it's crazy. So you and I have to figure it out.
Yep.
Instead of everybody else. And I don't understand. I think it's the most consumer hostile market. You go and you look at power tools. Like, you came from construction, right?
Yeah.
Every single power tool company has repair information available and parts. You get a Makita, you get a DeWalt, and you need a new clutch for your drill, and they will sell it to you, because if they don't, the word's going to get out in the construction community, right? If DeWalt stopped selling repair parts, no one would buy DeWalts anymore.
Exactly.
So how do they get away with this in the smartphone world? I don't understand.
I don't know. But it's good for us, as the two largest cell phone repair channels on YouTube.
They're going to keep making these fragile things made of glass, right? You got Samsung has glass on the front and the back. Yeah. So as long as everybody is out there making very fragile devices that are thin, we're going to keep teaching you how to swap the batteries, how to fix the glass, how to fix the lenses on the cameras. Yeah. It's a target-rich environment for people that are looking to teach people how to fix their broken stuff.
Well, good. Well, now we know what the ideal smartphone is for the CEO of iFixit. I agree 100%. Even MKBHD mentioned something about having a thicker battery in his phones. So I think, you know, from a consumer standpoint, having a bigger battery is just better all around.
It's time to end this design anorexia, making things thinner and thinner and thinner, to the point where you can't even play Pokemon on your phone.
Exactly. If you can't play Pokemon Go on your phone, there's no point in even having
a phone. No point in living, right? I mean, really, this is what we come to. What level are you at?
I haven't downloaded it yet.
You gotta get going.
I'm working on that. After this, I'll do it. Well, thanks for having me here at the studio of iFixit. I've really enjoyed this time. If you haven't subscribed to their channel yet, iFixit, they have fantastic repair guides, even pictures in a blog format. It is fantastic.
Our goal is to teach people how to fix everything that they have.
There we go. Thanks for watching.